Welcome to Web of Science, a quick introduction. Since Web of Science is a subscription-based database, you must access it by going through the library's website. Go to medlib.bu.edu. Here underneath Find Articles, the link to Web of Science is second. You'll need to log in using your BU username and password. Web of Science is a major source for articles in a wide range of fields and is a great place to find articles from scientific journals that may not be included in PubMed. It's also the best database to find the number of times an article has been cited. The basic search is best used if you have a known item you are looking for. In the drop-down menu here, select the title, and then copy-paste or type in the title of the article you're looking for. Then hit Enter or click Search. And if the item is indexed in Web of Science, it will come up here. And here you can see it records the number of times cited, which in this case is 4. For all other searching, it's best to use the advanced search. Advanced searching in Web of Science is a lot like computer programming. You must tell the database what the item is you're looking for based on these field tags. The most common one to use is topic. That's like searching for a keyword. So what you have to do in this box is put in TS equals and then the word you're searching for. I'm going to be searching for the impact of a vegetarian diet on cardiac disease in women. So for the first part of my search, I want to look for vegetarian. I'm going to put in vegetarian now. But Web of Science doesn't use an indexing list like many other databases. It doesn't use a basic list of terms that all articles are tagged with. Instead, it's just basic keyword searching like you might find in Google. In this case, then, you must think of all the synonyms that you possibly might need for your term you're looking for. So looking at this, I might want vegetarian, and it might also be called vegetarians. To make the database search for both vegetarian or vegetarians, all I need to do is put a wildcard on the end of vegetarian. In this database, the wildcard is the asterisk. By putting this on, the database will now search for vegetarian or vegetarians, and I don't have to type both words into the search box. Now hit search. And instead of bringing me out to the search results, it keeps a listing of them down here at the bottom. This lets me build up all the different terms I might want to use and then combine them later. So for the next part of my search, I want to look for cardiac disease. Since cardiac disease is a two-word search term, I need to put it into quotation marks so that I will search for both words together. So I'm going to put in cardiac disease in quotes. Now, cardiac disease has a lot of synonyms, and unfortunately, we can't use the wildcard for this since the different synonyms are very different words. So I'm going to put in or, and then heart disease. I'm also going to put in or cardiovascular disease. This is the second part of my search. Then I'll hit search, and now you can see we have vegetarian or cardiac disease. Now this database doesn't let you limit by gender or age or ethnic group. You have to put that into your search terms. There isn't a limit later on in your search results to limit to just say women. So we have to put that in ourselves. So I'm going to put in TS equals women, and in this case I'm going to use the wild card where the E would go. This will now look for women or woman. But I'm also going to put in or female with an asterisk at the end. That will let me look for female or females. Now I hit search. So here now we have the three separate terms that we're using for our search: vegetarian, cardiac disease, female. I want to combine these all. So click off the checkbox next to the terms, say combine with and then hit combine. You can now see we get 167 results. Click on that hyperlinked number to see them. Web of Science automatically sorts by publication date, newest to oldest. That's what you usually see in most databases. But Web of Science is the best database for looking at a number of times an article has been cited, and you can sort by that. So on this drop-down menu, I'm going to select time cited highest to lowest. A more highly cited article most likely is very important to the topic I'm looking into, so it's great to be able to sort that way. And if I want to be able to see what articles have cited this article, say for instance I really like this article and I want to know what articles have cited it since 1996, the number of times cited is actually a hyperlink, and if I click on it, it will bring up a listing of all the articles that have cited that article. It's a great way to find more information. I'm going to go back to my search results, and I'll show you quickly. You can also view what citations are within this article without getting the full text. So if I click out to it, here you can see again the time cited, but you can also see the cited references within the article. And that number again is hyperlinked, and you can see all of the references without having to get the full text of the article. I'm going to go back to my search results, since I want to show you the limits on the left-hand side. You can limit by a Web of Science category or document type. You can see exactly how many, for instance, book chapters are here. If you click on these items, the drop-down menu will open up and show you what research areas are available. As you can see, it's mostly the limiting is mostly based on research area or article type. You could also do publication years. That is the most frequently useful limit for searching on Web of Science. You can also sort by languages. So if you only speak English, or for instance, if you speak a second language as well, say you also speak German, click off both of those and then hit refine, and the articles available only in a language you don't speak will no longer show up. Now you may notice that we're also getting some articles on vegans in addition to vegetarians. You're not interested in a vegan diet, the diet that excludes eggs and dairy. You're only interested in the impact of a vegetarian diet. This is sometimes a weakness in Web of Science. It may pull up articles that aren't precisely about what you're looking for, because often that one topic is talked about in conjunction with another topic. So the way you get rid of that other topic is to use a not. Let me show you how to do that. I'm going to click on Advanced Search, and I'm going to do the vegetarian part of the search again. I'm going to do TS equals vegetarian, not TS equals vegan, with a wildcard at the end. This will pull up only articles about vegetarians, not vegans, so that will get rid of that aspect of the articles for you. Now hit search, and it saved all the things you've done so far, so you don't have to retype in women or cardiac disease. So you just select to combine this topic with the women and the cardiac disease, combine with and, hit combine. And you can see that I eliminated about 35 articles. So that narrowed your searching down a little bit. I'm going to view these results. You can see that it's still sorting by time cited. Now again, let's look at this article that we think is a good one. You can use a good article to help you further refine your search and find more good articles. So I'm going to click out to this article. And again, you can see the time cited is on the right-hand side, and you can view all the articles that have cited it, which can help. And you can also view its cited references. There's a related record search where Web of Science runs a behind-the-scenes algorithm to figure out articles that might be related to this one. You just click to view it, to view all of them. But you also can look at the keywords. Now there's Keywords Plus and there's Author Keywords. There is no indexing in Web of Science, but authors are allowed to put in keywords that they think are important to this article. And also Web of Science tosses in some keywords that it thinks are relevant. Since it's very important to think of synonyms when you're running a search in Web of Science, it's good to look at the keywords listed here. For instance, you might realize that dietary fiber has something to do with what you're looking into, so you might want to add that in as a search term to help further narrow your searching. One final thing about Web of Science is that it is useful to help you find contact information for authors of an article. If they have it, they put in an address to request a reprint, and they put in addresses for the authors. And also if they have it, which in this case they don't, but if they do have it, they will put in the author's email addresses so you can contact them. Thank you for watching a quick introduction to Web of Science. For more information about this or any other library resources or services, please feel free to contact the reference desk at 617-638-4228 or refquest@bu.edu.